They're a little hard to find right now, but COVID-19 detection tests are out there.
There's the PCR tests, which detect the genetic material of the virus, and then there's the rapid antigen tests, which detect part of the protein of the virus.
Amy Karger, associate professor in the Department of Lab Medicine and Pathology at the University of Minnesota's Med School, says, yes, while it's true that the PCR test is considered the gold standard of testing, there are pros and cons. First, PCR tests take longer.
It's really frustrating and challenging when you're sitting there waiting for that result, and most people may be going about out in the community, you know, spreading the virus if they don't have the result back.
Cost isn't an issue in our state, where PCR saliva tests are subsidized by the government, but over-the-counter rapid tests are generally cheaper at around $25 or so for two tests.
Convenience of being able to do the testing in your own home, having that result right away would tell that person, hey, you need to quarantine immediately, versus PCR where you're having to wait before you know what that answer is.
How worried should I be about using a rapid test and about false negatives?
You could worry about the false negatives, but in a lot of situations, people are using rapid tests in cases where they wouldn't bother or take that extra step to go get a PCR test. Doing testing is better than not doing any testing. It's pretty unlikely that people are going to do weekly PCR testing, for example, but they may be more inclined to do a weekly rapid at-home test because it is so easy and convenient.
Another instance where a rapid test might be more helpful than a PCR test: at the end of a COVID recovery cycle.
PCR should definitely not be used to determine whether you can come out of quarantine, because there are people who can stay positive with PCR for days, weeks, even months, because that PCR is so sensitive and can detect basically dead virus that's not capable of transmission.
And while there may be newer, more accurate, and cheaper tests available on the horizon, Karger says she thinks it's not about coming up with a newer and better.
I do anticipate, given the push for at-home testing, that there is going to be more new tests coming out, but I frankly don't think we necessarily need more new tests. I think what we have now is fantastic. We just need to make more of the tests we have and get them out to people and ramp up production so people can find them rather than having to go from pharmacy to pharmacy looking.
So Sharon, it sounds like the best test is the one that you can get your hands on, right? Where can we find any of these right now?
Exactly right. You know, what did you call it in the beginning of the show? It was like winning the lottery.
So yeah.
Personally, I've had some luck calling around different pharmacies before heading over there and asking if they have any in stock. And sometimes if you ask really nicely, they will tell you, no, we don't have any in stock here, but we heard the town over got a whole shipment this morning. So that's kind of how you can navigate the system, and also how you can avoid going from pharmacy to pharmacy, pharmacy hopping, and possibly spreading the virus. And of course, that is for an antigen rapid test. And if you are hellbent on getting a PCR test and going to a testing site and you don't know where to go, you can find all of that information on our website, care11.com, or you can text the word virus to our ZipWhip number. That's 763-797-7215. Again, a reminder, do not call that number, just text it. Rena.
All right. Thank you, Sharon.